So you might be wondering, is Squarespace good for videographer portfolio websites? What are the pros? What are the cons? I've been a website designer for 15 years. I've built some portfolio sites for professional videographers of different stripes on different platforms, and I can give you some of the pros and cons of Squarespace as a solution for a videographer portfolio website. And then I'll show you how I would go about building it and a template that I actually made specifically for videographers. All right, what are some of the pros of Squarespace for a videographer website? Squarespace has a really clean design, but it also has a lot of freedom. So you can get a good look, but it's also easy to over-clutter things. Other portfolio sites, they lock you in a little more to a particular look or a particular style or kind of whatever that the particular template is. Squarespace, you pretty much have a blank canvas. So if you're very opinionated about visual design, as a lot of video pros are, you may appreciate the level of control that you have with Squarespace compared to some of the simpler portfolio site builders out there. It's not as fully granular as something like Webflow, but if you're looking at DIY, you're probably not going to touch Webflow anyway. Another big plus of Squarespace for video pros is that it can serve as a kind of operating system for your whole business if you want it to. 10 years ago when I started designing in Squarespace, it wasn't like this, but over the past decade, they have really built out a whole suite of tools for small businesses. And there's a few in particular that can work really well for videographers. So Squarespace has a built-in scheduling tool called Acuity. They acquired it a couple years ago. I actually was using Acuity before Squarespace bought it. Now it's integrated right into the Squarespace dashboard, so you can schedule discovery calls with clients. Acuity is a really powerful scheduling tool, and it's built right into Squarespace. So that's cool. Squarespace also offers invoicing now. So you can create proposals, send them over, turn them into invoices when they're accepted, and get paid. You know, as a custom web designer, I do projects in the thousands and tens of thousands of dollars. That's a lot of credit card fees. Squarespace now offers ACH payments in the US. So if you're US-based, you can take ACH payments for a 1% fee instead of 3% or more, whatever it is for cards these days. I've moved almost all of my web design billing onto ACH now for that same reason, lower fees. When you're dealing in those larger amounts, it just makes sense. And email marketing. You used to have to hook up a MailChimp account to Squarespace in order to be able to send out emails. They've developed their own in-house email tool. It's relatively simple. It doesn't have a lot of the complex automations and stuff that a MailChimp or something would have. But for a videographer, what are you sending out emails about? Probably new work or awards you won or something like that. And if you're posting it as a blog post, every new blog post you make to Squarespace, they prompt you, they say, hey, do you want to send this out as an email campaign as well? And with just a couple clicks, you can turn the blog post into an email, same branding and everything, and send it out. So it could not be easier to keep people updated on your work. You can also sell a lot of things on Squarespace. Most video pros are service people, but if you're getting into products at all, whether it's digital products or courses or content memberships, Squarespace can do all that. So you can sell merch, you can sell courses, you can sell content membership, you can sell digital products or files. It used to be when somebody came to me wanting to do e-commerce, if e-commerce was their main thing, I would set them up on Shopify. But Squarespace has really grown in the e-commerce space. And so if you're looking to sell stuff, Squarespace can handle that too. And you can even buy your domain name and set up your professional branded at your domain G Suite email also through the Squarespace dashboard. So if you want, you literally can manage every aspect of your video business through Squarespace. All right, so what are the cons of using Squarespace if you're a videographer? You're limited to 30 minutes of native video storage. Now you can beautifully embed Vimeo videos, YouTube videos, and if you know how to manage embed codes, you can embed literally anything that's embeddable. But if you want to natively upload your videos to Squarespace, and there are cases where it's cool to do that. So background videos, for example, if you want a background video in a section, like I'll show you in a minute, but say you upload the first minute of your reel as a background video on your homepage, it will play natively on a lot of mobile browsers. Embedding a YouTube or Vimeo video as the background will not autoplay on most browsers because they disable that kind of thing. But somehow how Squarespace has set up the code of their natively uploaded videos, they display on a lot of mobile phones. That's a cool benefit. And So you're limited to 30 minutes native video upload to Squarespace. Most of you are probably using Vimeo or some type of file sharing service to deliver your final files because they're huge. And Squarespace does allow some native video hosting, but it's limited to 30 minutes on most plans unless you add a digital product add-on. I think it's an extra $9 a month. You get 10 hours of video storage. $29 a month, you get 50 hours. And whatever the highest tier is, you get unlimited video storage. But you're only really going to use that if you're building membership content or courses that involve a lot of video that you want securely hosted within Squarespace, and you don't want to manage that through, say, your Vimeo account. It's not going to be a deal breaker for most video pros. Another con is that the costs can add up if you're using a lot of these different Squarespace services because they're billed independently. So website hosting with Squarespace is $16 or $23 a month for the two base plans. Email marketing starts at $5 a month, and the scheduling tool starts at $16 a month. If you're really strapped for cash and it's more important to you to save money than to have all these tools under one roof, so to speak, I can recommend Card as a very cheap, it's $19 a year, one-page website builder. I'll link to that in the description. Cal.com is an extremely powerful free scheduling tool. And then Mailerlite, if you're looking to run an email list with under, I think, 500 people at no cost, Mailerlite is free and relatively easy to use. You would just have to hook all those tools together, which can get complicated, right? You want to spend your time making videos, not running your website and email list and everything. The trade-off there with Squarespace is you might end up paying a little more each month, but it's all under one login. I will say, if you don't need anything but just a very simple portfolio website and you're a videographer, Format has some nice videographer templates. So I'll link to them too in the description. You can check that out. All right. So how would I go about building a portfolio site for a video pro on Squarespace? Well, I already have. Let me show you. You've got this big, beautiful background video for the first section, and it's like the first minute of the reel. So the reel pops up in a modal like this with a big fat play button. And so you can show off your reel. People can click right from there to go over to your gallery or contact you. Close that out. And then going further down the homepage, you've got a couple cool things going on. You've got the logo scroll here of brands you've worked with. And then we've got call outs here for each of your major services with GIFs as the thumbnail image for these videos. So just asking you to click play. Some room for testimonials from your clients. And then you've got your three most recent posts that get pulled in, your three most recent portfolio events that get pulled onto the homepage. And a real simple footer. If you're multilingual, you can highlight that at the bottom. And then links to all your socials and a contact button. So that's the homepage. Then there's service pages. So if you have different categories of video that you do, you can create service pages that highlight each of those different types of work. So you can have some text there, and then I use the pin block to create this nice scrolling effect. And so it pulls in posts from your portfolio that are tagged with that category. Features the video real prominently right there. That's a YouTube video embedded, but with a custom thumbnail. So it has that nice clean look and just the play button instead of all the YouTube detritus. And then you've got info about the project, and you can put a whole narrative down here if you want. You can put galleries of BTS stills, you know, all that kind of stuff. These could be whatever you want. This is built on Squarespace's blog functionality rather than their portfolio functionality. And so it allows for categories and sorting by category and some of that kind of stuff that you can't do with Squarespace's portfolio functionality. Then we've got the All Work page. There's breadcrumbs that go back to that from every single post. That's a custom feature I coded into this template. But yeah, you've got your work page, and so you can filter the types of videos that they see. And then there's the About page. It can be as long or as short as you want. This version is pretty short, although you could build it out with more sections if you wanted. Squarespace is extremely extensible and flexible. And then the page that you're hoping every future client ends up on, the contact page. where you do have links to your socials and stuff. You can put words about your process, what you want them to do, but basically, simple contact form. Don't make it any more complicated than it needs to be. This is a fun new little feature Squarespace just added in. I enabled it for this template, is this little highlight that highlights the first field, just begging people to fill it out. And then the other feature up here in the nav is a language selector. So you can disable that if you don't want a multilingual site. But if you're a videographer who works in multiple countries and multiple languages, Squarespace has a Weglot integration that allows you to, with just a few clicks, create multilingual versions of your site. Got info about that in the documentation. And then let me show you a couple more pages that aren't linked in the nav, but I think would be really useful. So the reel page, that's where you upload your reel and have these buttons, these action buttons. So this page is basically popped up with some special code on the homepage on that modal button. If you use social media and you're wondering what to do with that one precious link in your Instagram bio, this is what you do with that. I know there's link in bio sites out there galore, Campfire and the like. What's nice about this is if you set this up as your link in bio, when they get here, they're already on your site. So it's a fully branded link in bio experience that you control. You've got your stuff right here, just how you want it. And then there's also a legal page for your legal stuff, terms and conditions. And there's a custom 404 page. So if they come via some bad or broken link from somewhere else, this will help them get back on track. And I've also added these custom little bits of code here for background video that allows you to play, pause, or unmute background video. Of course, it's muted by default. But if you had background video that had cool audio that you wanted to be able to showcase, you can do so using the custom background video controls. And then, this is not a public page, but I've created a template manual. Walks you through the basics of Squarespace and also some of the unique features of this template. So how to manage different parts of it. And how you buy it is you go to my site, strongsites.co, click on the Bokeh template, and you'll see a lot of the features and stuff that I've talked about here. You can also hire me to build this site out with your information, with your content, if you don't even want to touch it. And then when you're ready, just click any of the buy template buttons. Like I said, I've been a professional web designer for 15 years. I know Squarespace in and out. I know my way around the web. And I'm excited about this template. I think it's going to make it easier for video pros, maybe like you, or maybe you're a web designer for one, to get online quick and looking good. Hit me up via the comments if you have any questions, and I hope this was helpful. Have a good one.